Hi everyone, in this video today let us discuss C-peptide test. What is C-peptide? This is one of the peptide made up of 23 amino acids, and this peptide is going to be removed during the synthesis of insulin. So C-peptide is going to be derived from the synthesis of insulin, but it is required for the synthesis of insulin because during the synthesis and release of insulin, this peptide chain should not be misfolded. So C-peptide prevents the misfolding of insulin structure, and this C-peptide is also required to bring interchain disulfide linkage between the two chains. We know that insulin is having the two chains, chain A as well as chain B. These two chains are having two interchain disulfide bridges. These bridges are formed in presence of C-peptide, which prevents the misfolding so that disulfide linkage can be formed in order to stabilize the insulin structure. In this way, C-peptide plays an important role in the synthesis of insulin. So whenever the C-peptide levels are going to be elevated, it is associated with the increased synthesis of insulin. In this way, the C-peptide levels give an indication of turnover of insulin synthesis. So today in this video, we are going to discuss what is the significance of C-peptide test, how it is going to be released, what are the normal levels, and in which conditions it is elevated and in which conditions it is lowered. All these things we will discuss in this video. Insulin is going to be released from the prehormones. The initial precursor is pre-proinsulin. This pre-proinsulin is having the 110 amino acids, which is going to be converted into proinsulin, where the N-terminal is going to be removed. And now this proinsulin is having 74 amino acids. So in this conversion, 36 amino acids are going to be deleted by signal transpeptidases. Now this proinsulin is the immediate precursor for the insulin. It can be converted into insulin, which is mediated by endopeptidases. And here around 23 amino acids are going to be deleted to produce insulin with 51 amino acids. Now these 23 amino acids which are deleted in this last step is nothing but the C-peptide. So C-peptide is going to be deleted where proinsulin is going to be converted into insulin. So this is the structure of pre-proinsulin. It is having the N-terminal. This N-terminal is going to be removed by signal transpeptidases. By action of these enzymes, this N-terminal is going to be removed such that the pre-proinsulin is going to be converted into proinsulin. Now proinsulin is still having the C-peptide chain, which is required for formation of disulfide bridges. Now in the proinsulin, disulfide bridges are formed in presence of C-peptide, but this C-peptide is not required for the insulin structure. Now another group of enzymes, endopeptidases, can cleave the C-peptide at the both of the attachments. By the action of this endopeptidase enzyme, the C-peptide is going to be removed from the insulin structure. In this way, proinsulin can be converted into insulin. Now both proinsulin as well as insulin are going to be stored and they can be released by exocytosis. So the levels of C-peptide is an indicator of levels of insulin. In this way, by measuring the C-peptide levels, we can assess the insulin levels within the body. Thereby, we can differentiate either type 1 or type 2 diabetes in the patients. When this test is required? One of the important indication of C-peptide test is to differentiate whether the patient is having a type 1 diabetes or they are having type 2 diabetes. In the type 1 diabetes, there is an auto-destruction of pancreatic beta cells resulting in the decreased insulin release. So in such conditions, the C-peptide levels are reduced. But in the type 2 diabetes, generally the insulin is intact, but the insulin is not working properly, resulting in the increased insulin resistance. In such conditions, we can observe some elevated levels of C-peptide because of increased levels of insulin during the resistance. In this way, C-peptide test can be used to differentiate type 1 as well as type 2 diabetes in the patients. Similarly, another important condition is the hypoglycemia, in which again the C-peptide test can be done. In the patients with recurrent hypoglycemia, with few of the symptoms such as excessive sweating, severe palpitations, awareness of heartbeat, along with some irregular heartbeat, confusion, increased appetite, and some blurred vision, fainting sensation, and even it can lead to severe hypoglycemia, resulting in convulsions. So these symptoms are observed in the patients, which occur repeatedly. Then C-peptide test can be done in order to assess the insulin levels, as well as in order to assess the action of antidiabetic agents. What are the normal values? The normal values of C-peptide are variable with the laboratory conditions. Generally, the normal range of C-peptide is falling in between 0.5 to 2.0 nanogram per ml. So whenever the C-peptide levels are elevated or reduced, it can indicate some abnormality in the patients. So the elevated levels of C-peptide mainly indicates that patients may have increased release of insulin, which may be due to any development of insulin resistance, particularly in the type 2 diabetes mellitus. Insulin resistance is going to be developed where insulin is not working properly. So in order to reduce the glucose levels, insulin is more released, resulting in the increased C-peptide levels. Similarly, in the patients with insulinomas, where excessive insulin is going to be released because of any cancer of beta cells, which results in the proliferation and release of more insulin, leading to elevated levels of C-peptide. So, a high levels of C-peptide may indicate some insulinomas in the patients. And during the treatment, these C-peptide levels are reduced, which indicates that the insulinomas are responding to the treatment. So, C-peptide levels are elevated in the patients with insulinomas. Similarly, in other conditions where antidiabetic agents are used, such as sulfonylureas, which are increasing the insulin secretion from the beta cells. So drugs like glipizide, glibenclamide, these are the sulfonylureas, they can increase the insulin release. So when they are excessively used, they can increase the C-peptide levels by promoting the insulin release. Not only the sulfonylureas, incretin mimetics and DPP-4 inhibitors, all these can increase the insulin release, which may elevate the C-peptide levels. Similarly, other conditions such as hypokalemia, when the potassium levels are reduced, otherwise in case of any renal failure, or in case of Cushing's syndrome where excessive cortisol levels are released, in all these conditions, insulin sensitivity is increased, resulting in the increased release of C-peptide. In this way, by elevated C-peptide levels, we can assess any of these conditions within the patients. When we can observe the low levels of C-peptide? So again, the low levels of C-peptide indicate the decreased sense of insulin. This is particularly observed in the patients with type 1 diabetes mellitus, where there is destruction of beta cells, resulting in the decreased insulin release. Otherwise, in those patients who are administered with excessive exogenous insulin, so when the insulin is given by outside and when it is repeatedly administered, it can reduce the insulin release by negative feedback mechanisms, so that we can observe the decreased levels of C-peptide. Finally, in the patients with Addison's disease, where there is decreased cortisol levels, again reduce the insulin synthesis, resulting in the decreased levels of C-peptide. Not only these conditions, in the patients with any liver failure, again results in the decreased C-peptide levels. So whenever the C-peptide levels are reduced, it indicates any of these conditions. Similarly, the patients who are undergoing the treatment for insulinomas, the C-peptide levels are gradually reduced, which indicates the patient is responding to the treatment. In this way, the C-peptide levels can be tested in order to assess many conditions. When they are elevated, particularly they indicate increased release of insulin, which is associated with type 2 diabetes, otherwise with the development of insulin resistance or insulinomas, are associated with drug usage such as sulfonylureas, incretin mimetics, DPP-4 inhibitors, or few of the metabolic conditions like hypokalemia, renal failure, or Cushing's syndrome. In all these conditions, we can observe increased levels of C-peptide. Similarly, lowering of C-peptide levels can be observed in the conditions such as type 1 diabetes, administration of exogenous insulin, or in the conditions such as Addison's disease. In all these conditions, we can observe the decreased levels of C-peptide. So that's about the significance of C-peptide test. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.